In this module, we're talking about acid-base titrations, and we're going to look at what the curves look like when we graph pH versus volume of a titrant. But first, let's talk about something called millimoles and its relation to molarity, because this is really nice. It makes our life a lot easier. The reason being that we most of the time are dealing in the lab with volumes that are in milliliters. So here we go. A millimole, milli means 10 to the minus 3, so 1 millimole is 1 times 10 to the minus 3 moles. And if you take the ratio millimoles over milliliters, it's the same ratio as moles over liters, which means the molarity of a solution, you can either calculate it by taking the millimoles over the milliliters or the moles over the liters. Same thing, right? Because the conversion factor, the 10 to minus 3, cancels on top and the bottom. So concentration of something, we can calculate it by taking the moles over the liters or millimoles over milliliters. Watch, you'll see. So we're going to start with titrating a strong acid with a strong base, meaning in our beaker or flask down there, we have a strong acid, hydrochloric acid, for instance, and in our burette or whatever our drops are coming out of, we have a strong base like sodium hydroxide. So there's the chemical reaction. And let's say that we're titrating 25 milliliters of 0.1 molar hydrochloric acid with 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide. If we plotted the pH versus the volume of sodium hydroxide added, it would look a lot like this. A couple things here. The point right here, when we've added as really close to the same number of moles of sodium hydroxide as we have moles of hydrochloric acid in there, that's called the equivalence point. And at the equivalence point, all of the hydrochloric acid has been used up with no extra sodium hydroxide around because it's all been converted to sodium chloride and water. Remember, these are strong acids and strong bases, so there's no real equilibrium going on here. And because what's the major species present in solution there are sodium chloride and water, the pH is just 7 at the equivalence point. Now, what happens before the equivalence point is that as we add those drops of sodium hydroxide, we use up some of the hydrochloric acid, and that means the pH starts rising. It becomes less acidic, but there's still some strong acid in there, so it's still fairly acidic, low pH. The sodium hydroxide is all used up because, you know, at that point down here, because it's been converted into sodium chloride and water, right? But it starts to rise. Notice it starts to rise sharply as we get close to the equivalence point, and right at the equivalence point, it's going up just really steeply. After the equivalence point, now we start adding more sodium hydroxide after all the hydrochloric acid has been used up. Now the pH starts going up again because we're adding hydroxide to a solution, increasing its basicity, and it starts to rise gradually here. The equivalence point you can calculate if we know this information up here. That's the point where the moles or the millimoles of acid is equal to the millimoles of base added. So we started with 25 mils of hydrochloric, 0.1 millimoles per milliliter or moles per liter, right? There we go. That's millimoles helping us out. Milliliters cancel. We get 2.50 millimoles of hydrochloric acid there initially, which means once we've added 2.50 millimoles of sodium hydroxide, we will be at the equivalence point. So, and that's because this is a 1-to-1 mole ratio. If this was like sulfuric acid, we need two of these, right? We need twice as much sodium hydroxide to get the equivalence point. But millimoles over millimoles per milliliter, it's 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide too. Gives us how many milliliters of sodium hydroxide at the equivalence point? 25. All right, that's a strong acid with a strong base. Let's go back here. So these are some numbers. How much the volume of hydroxide added, millimoles of hydroxide. It's 0.1 molar, so these numbers are really easy to get. How many millimoles of hydrogen ion are remaining? So we start out with 2.5. If we added 0.5 millimoles of hydroxide, there's 2.5 minus 0.5 is 2. If we add another 0.5 millimoles of hydroxide, 2 minus 0.5 is 1.5, and so on. And now notice the volume's increasing, right? Each time we're adding 5 more mils, so 25, 30, 35, 40, and so on. And so to calculate the concentration, we have to take the of hydrogen ion millimoles over the volume, milliliters, right? 2 over 30, 1.5 over 35. So like this, after 5 mils of sodium hydroxide have been added, we have 2 millimoles of hydrogen ion over 30 mils of solution. It gives us this molarity, and the pH is negative log of that, which is 1.18. This table here, I got it from a book. Their sig figs are off. There should only be two past the decimal in these, because these guys right here give us only two sig figs. And then here we have the equivalence point. pH is 7. And then past the equivalence point, okay, it'd probably be worthwhile for you guys to do some of these calculations, get these numbers. But there we go. Next, we're going to titrate a weak acid with a strong base, like acetic acid and sodium hydroxide. The curve will look like this. Notice that we start out at a higher pH than we did with the strong acid. We're doing 25 mils of 0.1 molar acetic acid with 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide. Because it's a weak acid, not all the molecules are dissociated. This is the reaction that we're dealing with. Now notice, in this region right here, the species present make this a buffer solution. What species are those? Well, after we've added just a little bit of sodium hydroxide, we're going to have some of the salt of its conjugate base, sodium acetate, or you know, the acetate ion around. We're also going to have some of the weak acid. So when you have a mixture of a weak acid and the salt of its conjugate base, you have a buffer solution. And why that's nice is that we can use the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation down here to calculate the pH at any point. Now, the equivalence point, it's going to be the same. It's going to be when the millimoles of sodium hydroxide is equal to the millimoles of acetic acid we started with. But notice it's a higher pH. Because at that point, at the equivalence point, what we have in solution, the species present, are sodium acetate, which is the salt of the conjugate base, and water. Which means that now what happens is sodium acetate, or the acetate, is in equilibrium, okay, with water, and this guy happens. So let's do it down here. We have this. We're running out of room, but we make acetic acid and hydroxide, and so the pH is higher. There's some sodium hydroxide at the equivalence point here. Then after the equivalence point, now we're adding more sodium hydroxide, and the hydroxide itself makes the pH climb. So here are some of the numbers. So for instance, after 5 mL of hydroxide have been added, we have, using the Henderson-Hasselbalch, the pH is equal to the pKa. Here the Ka, you're told, for acetic acid is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5th, if you can read that. And so pKa is negative log base 10 of the Ka, plus log of the concentration of the base over the acid. Now here, I just put the millimoles here because you're going to divide this by the volume. It's the same volume at that point, so the volumes cancel. You get the same ratio. Anyway, we get 4.14 for the pH, and so on. And finally, we're going to titrate a weak base with a strong acid. The first two are acids being titrated with a base. So we started with an acid in the beaker or the flask and added from the burette or the dropper the sodium hydroxide, the base. Now we're going to have some ammonia in solution. Excuse me. That's a weak base. And we're going to be adding hydrochloric acid from the burette or the dropper. And so this is the reaction of what happens. And just like with the weak acid and the strong base, so the weak base and a strong acid, initially we have a buffer solution because after we add even one drop of the hydrochloric acid, there's some ammonium and there's also some ammonia. There's a weak base and its conjugate acid, or vice versa. So we have a buffer solution and we can use the Henderson-Hasselbalch equation. At the equivalence point, we've added the same number of moles of hydrochloric acid as we do have ammonia, and notice that the pH now is lower than 7 because what's happening here is the ammonium ion, which is a weak acid, is reacting with water to make hydronium and ammonia. And so we have some hydronium or hydrogen ion in solution there, lowering the pH. And then after we go past the equivalence point, then the pH is dropping due to just there being excess hydrochloric acid.